Things got red hot this week for embattled New York State Senator Majority Leader Pedro Espada. His health care clinic was raided, civil charges were filed, and criminal charges may follow. Right now, he's being investigated by the FBI, the IRS, two U.S. attorneys, the New York State Attorney General's Office, and the Bronx DA.
Pedro Espada's gargantuan appetite for sushi from these two Mamaroneck restaurants apparently ended up giving him a massive case of political indigestion.
FBI and IRS agents raided State Senator Pedro Espada Jr.'s health clinic on Wednesday, removing boxes of documents, potential evidence that could be vital to a criminal investigation of the Bronx Democrat by State Attorney General Andrew Cuomo and federal prosecutors.
And what I do not like is somebody to use us for your own gains, personal gains. It really is not right.
This was an illegal and unlawful attempt to gain control of the Senate and reverse the will of the people who voted for a Democratic majority.
The apparent coup took place late this afternoon when Republicans summoned reporters to the Senate chamber to witness a historic change in leadership. That's when word got out that two Democratic senators, Pedro Espada Jr. of the Bronx and Hiram Montserrat of Queens, had essentially defected.
This is not a person who can say, well, I had no idea about the law and the regulations. He's literally an elected official. And this conduct was egregious.
According to the Attorney General, the Espadas ordered $20,000 worth of sushi, 200 individual meals that was delivered from here to their Mamaroneck house about a mile away. It was just a year ago that I first told you that Espada, seen here hiding from me in the orange ski hat outside his $700,000 Mamaroneck home, didn't live in his Bronx district. But the meals were just the tip of the iceberg. Cuomo says that Espada used his Soundview Health Clinic for the Poor as a personal piggy bank, looting $14 million for such things as family trips to Las Vegas, Miami, and Puerto Rico, a house allowance for a Bronx condo so he could claim it as a base to run for Senate, and a $9 million severance package if he loses his Soundview job for any reason. The loot also reportedly paid for Espada's political expenses, including $100,000 worth of political mailers like these I showed you last year. The expenses were never reported to campaign authority.
This was not the private playground of Mr. Espada. These were public funds.
On a theoretical basis, the potential federal crimes would be mail fraud, wire fraud, theft of government funds, and conspiracy.
So government raids, claims of millions looted, and counterclaims of a political witch hunt. What's next? New York State Senate Majority Leader Pedro Espada is here to respond to the charges. Welcome, Senator. Well, we were talking to State Senator Pedro Espada, but he didn't like our questions. And as you probably can notice now, I'm sitting here with Marcia Kramer, and the good senator has left us. He just didn't like the way things were going in the conversation. I also want to give an apology because I said I characterized him as the little man in the orange hat, and what I was referring to was the picture of the person far away in the video. So no offense to the senator, but he took offense at a great many things, most specifically our desire to have him answer some specific questions.
This has obviously taken a toll on the institution, on the families of all the senators, on our work, on the 19.5 million people throughout the state that witnessed chaos and dysfunction at its highest levels. I profoundly apologize. That's not the result. That was a point along the bumpy road.
This enrolled.